Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making corn cookies. And I had never heard of corn cookies until recently when Rick and I and Chelsea and Carter went to Wallace Station to have lunch. And after lunch, I bought three cookies to bring home and eat. They're all gone. And I was really anxious to see what the corn cookie was like. I thought maybe it was made out of corn flakes, and I asked at Wallace Station, and the lady who was attending to me said that it was cornmeal. So I decided to make up a recipe that I thought would be like the cookie that I brought home, because it was very good. It was one of those large cookies, so we'll make them giant size as compared to a normal size cookie. All right, let's get started. We start with a large bowl. And then to that, we're going to add one stick of butter. That's the same as 1/2 cup of butter. And it should be at room temperature, or at least softened a bit. And then we're going to add some sugar. This is 3/4 cup of granulated sugar. Next is some brown sugar, 1/4 cup of brown sugar, firmly packed. And then I'm adding 1/2 tablespoon of vanilla extract. Once I get those in my mixing bowl, I'm going to use an electric mixer and get them mixed until light and fluffy. Here's what we have. And next I'm going to beat in 1 egg. So I have 1 egg sitting here. I'll just put that in. And here it goes. And this is what it looks like when the egg has been beaten into the mixture. I'm coming over here to where I have an empty bowl, and into this bowl I'm going to put 1 cup all-purpose flour and also 3/4 cup of yellow cornmeal. So that's where our corn comes from for these cookies. Now we have some other dry ingredients. We have 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, put those in here, and mix all of this together before you go back to the main mixture. So this looks pretty good. And what I'm going to do is put a little at a time into this mixture and beat it in. So when I come back, I will have it all incorporated. And there we have it. And this is our mixture. Doesn't that look good? Actually, it's reminding me of the cookie and the taste of that cookie. So it might look a little strange to you because it's a little grainy, but that's part of the character of the cookie caused by the cornmeal. So what we're going to do at this point is just kind of smooth it down using a spatula like this. And I'll probably get some more of that off. But for now, just to explain what happens. Then we're going to take some plastic wrap, put it over the top, and then place this in the refrigerator and let it chill until you can work with it. After your cookie dough has set in the refrigerator for about 4 hours, it's going to look like this. It's very stiff. So I have a spoon here that I'm going to use to lift this out onto a cutting board. And what I would like to do is manage to get it cut into pieces so that I'll have equal amounts. So I'm thinking that this will make 6 nice large cookies. So that means that if I can get this into a ball so that it is symmetrical, then I can cut it down the middle, and then I will know I need 3 cookies per side. So we'll just go down the middle here, and that will approximate the 2 halves of it, and then we can do thirds. If you thought that you wanted this to be 8, then of course make it into fourths on each side, but I think probably going with this cut here and this cut here, and we can adjust. But I'll form one for you, and then, you know, all the others are going to be formed the same way. It is workable, even though it's very cold. And what you want to do is make it into a circle, but it needs to have some thickness to it or else it will burn. And it will grow in size, probably, in the oven because of our addition of baking soda. So there's our first corn cookie. We have our cookies formed, and I put them on a parchment paper in a baking pan, and this goes to a 350 degree oven. Now you see I'm only getting 6 cookies, and they're large cookies, but I actually cut my recipe in half. So if you want to have a dozen cookies that are this size, then you need to double each ingredient. Okay, to the oven, and when they start turning a light brown, then I know they're kind of chewy inside. They can be taken up if they appear to be done. When you let them get browner, they're going to be more crisp. So we'll just take them up and then we'll be going through the cooling process. I let our giant corn cookies bake for 12 minutes. And they look like this, and they are certainly ready to come out of the oven. And you can pretty easily get a spatula under them and then transfer them to a cooling rack. So I'll be doing that, and then I'll come back and show them a little further and take a bite. I've had the cookies cooling for about 20 minutes, and they're certainly touchable. They're a little warm to the touch, but I like them warm. So I'm going to go ahead and remove them from my cooling rack and put them on a nice dish. They're very large. If you don't like them this large, then just make more of them in a smaller quantity. If you want to, you could use maybe 8 on one tray, and then they would be a smaller circumference. But our plate of cookies looks like this. These are corn cookies. I hope you love them. So here is my place setting, and I have milk to go with the cookies. I thought that would be perfect. And I think a serving here is going to be one cookie. Don't think you need more than one, if that much. And I think I'm going to break this in two, give you an idea of what the center is like and the texture. There you go. And I like the crispy part, but there's more of the other part, so I'll take some of the inside part. I'm tasting for taste, for texture, all of that. It's really good. I will say it's as good as the one we bought. I wouldn't want to brag and say that it's better, but it tastes really good. And if you've never had a corn cookie, you just need to put some cornmeal in with the flour in the right proportion, and it will come out like this. And it looks wonderful and it tastes wonderful. I really love these.